Don't forget, when you hit that subscribe button, make sure you hit that bell so you can get all the notifications of all the latest videos. Thank you for being part of the Jamers. What up, James? It's your boy Toot James, and I'm back in the building. Another video of Marvel Contest of Champions. And today is Tuesday, and you already know it is the champion of the week. Now, the champion need to be featured because I feel like a lot of people really don't appreciate this champion in the game. And I don't know if it's because of the fighting style, the way the champ looks. I don't know. To me, this champion is very versatile or versatile, whichever one you prefer. And he brings a lot to the table. And he's like your poor man's version of other champs. But he works if you know how to use him right. So without further ado, your champion of the week is Howard the Duck. Yes, Howard the Duck, a.k.a. HTD. Now, reason being why he's the champion of the week. I mean, dude, passive critical damage rating increase by 40.49% on his crack few fury. He also gets an armor rating by 156.52 when the active armor up is activated with 8 stacks. His SP1 reduces armor, attack, block proficiency, regeneration rate, physical resistance, crit chance, and critical damage by 6% for the remainder of the fight. Now, although it's only a portion, dude, it can affect all those. That is a game changer. My favorite is his SP2. He fries out a barrage of strain bullets. Each effect has a 30% chance to activate. Heal block, power drain, poison, armor break, power lock, shock, and weakness. Dude, come on, man. This is like an all-in-one package. All-in-one package. Like I said, yes, his fighting style is definitely more clunkier than Hulkbuster, yes. But, dude, he brings a lot to the table. So let's go ahead and feature Howard the Duck, a.k.a. HTD, your champion of the week. Like I say, man, I think people just don't know how to utilize this guy right. He doesn't really need to be duped. And it's like little things count in fights. And little stuff like that, reducing rates of, you know, resistance and all that, it makes a huge difference, man. Makes a huge difference. So here we go. Let's go ahead. We're going to get hit a bit. We're going to see how his base defense looks. See if he's not like one of those little noodle champions like Electro or like Rocket Raccoon. But from my personal experience, he is a tanker. So look, you see, you get the 8 armor stack right off the gate. So you see, he's not going to take that much damage right out the gate. There goes that Fury. See, the Fury stacks when he gets hit. And then now you go ham. See, just go ham. I always like to use the heavy because it helps stack up. And it extends the Fury too. Now we're going to use the SP2 if he stays alive. Look, boom. Heal block and shock already. And that was my first time activating it. And he already gets heal block and he gets shock. So I'm saying, man, he's definitely your poor man Vision, your poor man Storm, your poor man Scarlet Witch. As far as, like, the things he can reduce with his specials. Like, he's the all-in-one champion. If they would give him a little better buff, he would be a pretty solid champion overall. We're going to go in again just to see how effective that SP2 is. So let's go ahead and recharge him up. And yes, I haven't ranked him up yet. So I know. Don't crab at me for his low rating. All right, so let's go back to tech. 4-star. And boom. Like I said, my best bet, use your heavies like you do Hyperion. I know he doesn't stack it like him, but it helps get the Fury bars stacked a little faster. Although he can get him automatically just by getting hit, as you've seen in the first fight. So we're going to go. I wish they would have gave us some better fights, man. Somebody with a little more health. But yeah, you know how the game go. All right, so we're going to go up against this Luke Cage. Like I said, you're going to see the armor up straight out the gate. See, he's taking his punches. I know that the sound from him getting hit is going to get annoying after a while. I know, trust me. See, so the fury stacks when he gets hit. See, you don't even got to do much. All right, so now we're going to go in. Use that SP2. Boom, power drain, weakness, and shock. So you get 3 debuffs in 1. And look, see, his fury goes up to stack 5. See, just eating away. Now we're going to try his SP1. Boom. Pretty strong. Pretty strong there. So like I say, man, you see right there. You see the example of the debuffs stacking on the SP2. I think he's worth it, man. If you got him, I say roll a dice with him. Give him a rank up. Definitely a better option than Iron Patriot and Spider-Gwen. Because I know a lot of people put him in that category. And he's definitely better than Luke Cage. So my recommendation, man, if you got Howard the Duck, show the man some love. You know what I'm saying? Give him a little chance. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Your champion of the week, Howard the Duck, A-A-A, I'm about to say A-A-A, A-K-A H-T-D. Yes, that's his new acronym from now on. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please like, subscribe, and share if you haven't already. Don't forget to hit that bell so you won't miss any notifications of my next future videos. Let me know if he's overrated, underrated. Let me know what level you got him. If you do got him, don't got him, duped. And let's open up this discussion and see you next week for the next champion of the week. This is your boy, Toot, James, and I'm signing out.